Sheila again, and now I'm going to show you how to sew the single dream apron and pillow. You've already cut it out. Here it is in the baggie, and we're going to take the kit out of the center of it and open it up. You will see that you have all the parts. The shower ribbon we'll put aside. The binding we'll also put aside for right now. You have the pillow that is folded in half, and that's the first thing we'll sew. Then you have the pocket front, the apron front, and the apron back. So we'll get to those parts in just a little bit. I've learned that I don't really have to pin much with the flannel, as it does stick together quite easily. I always like to start at the top and sew towards the fold in a quarter inch seam. Backstitch at the beginning and at the end. And oftentimes I will be making 5 or 6 kits at one time, so I can just keep funneling the pillows through without having to cut the thread in between. But I'm just showing you how to make one right now. Trim your threads. And turn the pillow right side out. I usually don't cut the corners at an angle, but I like to use my favorite turning tool. You might have a point turner, but I prefer a chopstick. And the seams do not have to be pressed open because the fiberfill will stuff them out. And then you get some quality fiberfill. Now here's a big wad. I won't put that wad all in there. I will tear it apart into smaller pieces. It will fit inside the pillow and make it a smoother, softer, less lumpier pillow. We want the pillow to be fairly full, but not hard or stiff. Poke it into the corners so it fills out. Not quite enough yet. There. That feels just right. Then, open your seams up just right there at the edges. Turn under about a quarter to 3/8 of an inch. Now we're ready to sew it. We've tucked our edges in on the to close the pocket, the pillow, and we're just going to sew across the top. Close to the edges. I do sew over pins. Some people don't like to do that. Do it quite well. And so then you'll trim your threads off and take the pins out, and you have your pillow that's already stuffed and sewn for the single bag. So we'll lay that aside for now and take the pocket. This fabric does not have an up and down to it. And so we will turn under a quarter of an inch and then another quarter of an inch, and that's the way we hem the pocket. There's no need to make the pocket double. It is quite strong enough to do it this way. And then just keep turning under a quarter of an inch as you sew across the top. And you're sewing close to the fold on the inside. If you you want to press this before you sew it, of course you can. But there really is no need to it. It seems to lie down quite nicely. So there's the pocket hemmed. Now take the front, which is the plain piece, and lay the pocket on top of it. And match the sides. I'm going to put just one pin on each side just to hold it. Match the bottom and the sides over here. And then fold it in half to find where the middle is, because we are going to put one row of single stitching down there and form actually two pockets. So put this in the machine, sew from bottom of the pocket to the top. Stitch at the top. So now you can see that we have the two pockets on the front of the apron. Then take the apron back, put right sides together, and put a few pins in just to hold it. Sometimes, you know, even though we cut these the same, sometimes they just don't quite match up at the top. One fabric is just a little stretchier than the other, and that's totally okay. You can trim off the extra. It's not exact like quilting is. And so you do have a lot of fudge room. So I just put a few pins in to hold the sides together before I stitch them. Then we'll stitch around on the three sides, not the top, but the side, two sides, and the bottom. So you'll notice that my edges aren't quite together. That'll be fine, because that edge will be turned in. Then remove your pins, and you might not have to pin as much as I did. You might have a walking foot on your machine that really enables this to be better. Because there are three thicknesses of fabric here, I do like to trim off the corners just a little bit at an angle to take some of the bulk out of the corner. And then turn it to the right side. Again, I like to use my favorite point turner, a chopstick. And you'll see how nice the pocket looks on top of the plain fabric with the printed fabric on the back. Now, if you want to, you can press this. There's really no need to. I just like to put a couple of pins just to make sure that the back side stays on the back, and that I have really correctly turned it here at the bottom. If if they see if the backside seems like it's rolling to the front a little too much, that's what I'm trying to prevent by pinning. So then lay it out, try to get the edges together. You see that they're not quite matching, but it's still fine. And so now we want to use our binding. Remember, the binding is folded into half, so we know exactly where the center of it is. And we want to find the center of the back, just approximate, doesn't have to be exact. And we're going to put right sides together of binding and the back of the apron. Since I do have a little fabric sticking out, I'm going to actually make my seam match up with the back and just cut off that extra. You can see how that's going together now. And this is just to secure the binding onto the back of the apron. So we're just going to sew a 1/4 inch seam across the back. Cut your threads. If you cut as you sew, it saves a lot of cleanup time later. Then we can take all the pins out, even not only with the binding, but also with the ones on the sides, because we no longer need them. We have sewn everything into place. And then turn the binding to, or maybe stretch the binding up. Then you're going to turn under 1/4 inch, as you can see. And then fold it over the stitching that you had. And so this makes the binding and the ties. I'm going to put one pin up there right now. And then just a couple of other pins, just to kind of keep things together, folding in 1/4 inch on each side and pinning. So you have a fairly narrow binding. And we'll do this on both ends. And then we just sew one long line of stitching. Don't worry about the end of the tie. We'll cut off whatever is uneven. Again, this binding or this apron is only used for 2 to 4 weeks. And so it doesn't have to be a perfect job like you would want with a quilt. So it's a good idea whenever you stop with the needle down and then stitch close to the two folded edges. This flannel seems to mold quite easily. It's very easy to work with. Just a little bit on it to straighten it. I keep wanting to say this is not rocket science. It's very easy to do. It's all straight stitching, and it's just, I think it's the comfort of the fabric that is what's so appealing. And patients who receive these are really surprised that someone thought of this idea for them. I used to do so much pinning on this before, but I'm finding out that you don't have to do that anymore. Because it is torn on the lengthwise, and so that's the strongest direction of the fabric. The binding, you're actually finished, because this is the last stitching that you have to do. You see how fast this has gone together. Now, if you do a good job of backstitching at the end, you can actually cut that off so it's a nice clean cut and you're all finished. Yeah. Take out any pins that you had, the apron is done. So, what you want to do then is take your baggie, put the pillow in the bag. Fold the apron in half, and I just like to gently take the ties and tuck them into pocket, and on the other side put in the shower ribbon, and be sure you sign the card and tell where you're from, and then put that in so that the little pink ribbon shows. Then gently inside the bag on top of the pillow, and it is ready to go to the doctor's office or the hospital to where it will be used. There is a single drain bag apron. Thanks for watching. Thank you.